This is me when I was younger. Even at a young age, I was proud to be Filipino. So why for so long did I reject my own culture? You're just proud to be part of something, not really knowing what it actually means. I grew up on Long Island, New York, where there aren't that many Filipinos. My brother and I made up almost half the Filipino population in our high school, but that's not really saying much since there were probably only about 5 Filipino kids in my grade. I never really knew what it meant to be Filipino. And like a lot of other kids, I was just trying to fit in. Throughout the years as I grew up, the line of what my own culture was started to blur. For lunch, instead of bringing leftovers, I started to bring sandwiches. For dinner, I begged my mom to cook American food, just because I wanted to be more American. But it wasn't even just back then. Even just recently in 2020, I wanted to learn a second language over the summer. I chose Korean instead of my own language, Tagalog, because I thought it'd be more useful, since a lot of people in the Philippines already spoke English. For a long time, I rejected my own culture, a part of who I was. But now that I'm older, I've been wanting to learn more about my own culture and about the history. I started to learn Tagalog, learn a little bit more about the history. I recently read this book called Brown Skin, White Minds by E.J.R. David. In the book, he talks about something called colonial mentality or internalized oppression. If you didn't know, the Philippines was colonized by a lot of countries, Spain for 300 years, Japan, and even the US for 50 years. For the majority of the time, the Philippines and our people have been oppressed. Therefore, it doesn't make it all that surprising that it has literally changed the way that Filipinos think. Colonial mentality is a form of internalized oppression that conditions colonized people to believe that their ethnic or cultural identity is inferior to Western culture or whiteness. Or in other words, involves uncritical rejection of anything Filipino and uncritical preference for anything American. Now, if you're watching this and you're Filipino, you might be thinking, am I like this? I've always been pretty in touch with my culture. But colonial mentality can manifest itself in a lot of different ways. It's laughing at your family members if they spoke English with a thick accent. It's thinking that anything made in the US is automatically better than things made in the Philippines. It's trying really hard to not be in the sun, since darker skin and flat noses are not considered beautiful. It's thinking that the US taught us so much, and we're way better off now. But are we? Although the Philippines is now under its own rule, colonial mentality still runs deep for both Filipinos and Filipino Americans. Colonial mentality is a mentality that can be passed from generation to generation, and your environment has a large part in how you're raised, the values that you soon start to hold, and your mindset that you approach the world with. Colonial mentality can start to have drastic consequences. Empirical evidence suggests that colonial mentality is highly linked to mental health and the well-being of Filipinos. The CDC reported that 45.6% of Filipino-American adolescents have thought about suicide, the highest rate among all ethnic groups. In 2008, the author found in a national sample of Filipino-Americans, there was a depression rate of almost 29.8%, almost 30%. Since Filipino culture and history is often presented in mythical, distorted, and interiorizing manner, such an identity crisis is believed to lead Filipino Americans toward the conclusion that there is no authentic Filipino culture and identity that one can be proud of, and thus may lead to the perception of inferiority toward anything Filipino. I can say for myself, I've had a lot of experiences like this. Growing up, I didn't really know what it meant to be Filipino, and I've only learned that from my parents or what I saw in the media. I really wanted to champion our own culture and to spread it with others. But to be honest, I didn't really know too much about the culture to begin with, and I didn't know what to champion. So what now? Where do we go from here? After hearing all this, it might be easy to say that people who have colonial mentality are bad, and people who don't have colonial mentality are good. But I don't think it's all that black and white. And the goal of this is not to reject American culture completely, and then flip to becoming Filipino-centric. I think the goal of this is to become more aware of the situation to recognize our biases and learn. By having a word to describe a concept, it allows us to bring meaning to it and to become more aware of our own thoughts, to learn more about ourselves and others in our community, to catch ourselves when we may be making fun of a family member for having a thick accent, or maybe helping to understand that family member who thinks that using whitening soap is the best thing in the world. You might think that these changes are small and that they have no real impact. But as we've seen from earlier, our thoughts, our actions, and our mindset have drastic consequences with how we show up in the world and interact with others. So I think the first step is awareness. To all my fellow Filipino people out there, I think we're part of such a cool culture. Sometimes even I forget that. Our culture is so full of joy, warmth, and camaraderie. It's a mix of many cultures, but I think that being in the middle can sometimes be beautiful. There is a middle ground where we learn to appreciate both cultures and what they both bring to the table. There are some things in this world that we can't really control and make us a part of who we are. But I don't think that should let us stop us from being who we want to be. And if you can't remember.